This is the 8-piece Instant Pot Accessory Kit from Costco. In this video, I'm gonna open up the box and show you all the different accessories and then chat a little bit about how you might use these accessories. I have my Instant Pot Duo Gourmet 6-quart over here so I can show you how all the accessories fit. You can see on the box it says 6-quart and 8-quart compatible. But I will mention that if you do have an 8-quart pot that you're cooking with primarily, you can find all of these accessories, not necessarily Instant Pot brand, but different brands of these accessories that are sized just a little bit bigger for the 8-quart. And if you go that direction, that'll just be maximizing your space using the bigger pot. Okay, let's get this open and see what we have. All right, everything looks like it's packaged together here. First thing on top is part of the egg steamer rack. And this has nice long legs so that you can use it for pot and pot cooking. I'll talk about that more in just a minute. Next thing here is a little pan with a lid. This is a cheesecake pan. It's stainless steel and it has the silicone edges. And the bottom of the pan comes out. So if you're cooking a cheesecake, you can remove it from the pan really easily. I haven't used the Instant Pot brand cheesecake pan, but my favorite other cheesecake pans that I always use have the removable bottom like this. Rather than the springform pan, I really like the removable bottom for cheesecakes. And here's the lid. It's kind of got a funny design in the middle here. I'm not sure what that's for. Show you how big to slice your cheesecake? I don't know. Then it's also got this little flap here that you can open up to let steam release. That's interesting. So the lid just pops back on like that. The lid is heat resistant, so you can use the lid in the Instant Pot for cooking. Next thing is another pan, but this one doesn't have the removable bottom. It's kind of dirty, kind of scuffed up a little bit. Well, and this one, same kind of lid. It has the little flap here as well. This is just a little divider so that you can put it in here and cook a few things at the same time without them running together. These can come in really handy if you're reheating leftovers or if you're just cooking for one and you want to cook little portions of different things at the same time. Last thing down here is the other part of the egg steamer rack. I'll show you how those two go together here in a second. So when the box says 8 pieces, they're counting the lid and the divider as all separate pieces. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7, 8, because this pan has a removable bottom. So that's your 8-piece accessory kit. I think it would have been a little more intellectually honest to say 3-piece or maybe 4-piece if you counted these two as separate things, but they chose to go with 8-piece. So these egg steamer racks are pretty fun. You can see they have the little holes for the eggs to sit in, and those are really nice for if you're doing deviled eggs and you want the yolk to be perfectly in the center. If you stand your egg up in these, it's going to come out perfectly in the center. And this is nice, you can stack these. It just kind of clips in here. And so you can have a layer of eggs on the bottom, layer of eggs on the top. That is nice. You can also put the pans like this, one pan here, put the other one on top. And you can cook eggs on the top, or you can cook the other pan on top, and you can lower them down into the Instant Pot at the same time. Now for a little chat about how you might use these different accessories. Of course, the egg steamer racks you can use for making boiled eggs. To do that, you're gonna put water on the bottom of your Instant Pot liner. Whenever you use a rack to have your food up above the bottom of the Instant Pot, there has to be something liquid down in the bottom to build up the pressure. So if you are gonna boil eggs, you put a cup or two of water down there. You can put your rack in, put your eggs in. If you want to do a double rack, you can put your other rack in there, put more eggs, and you're ready to go. Also, if you're cooking something like lava cakes and you want to do a double layer of something, you can cook your ramekins in here like this, get some down on the bottom, get some up on the top. You could do poached eggs this way. In here with these regular sized ramekins, I could get 6 of the ramekins in at a time, which is super handy. Also, if you have the silicone egg bite molds to make the Starbucks sous vide egg bites that everybody loves, you can make a double layer of those using these racks. So that's a few ideas of how you can use the two racks together. You could also use just the tall rack like this. And this is really handy for when you're cooking something on the bottom of the Instant Pot, maybe like a curry or a sauce with meat or something, and you want to cook rice at the same time. You would get your stuff going on the bottom, and then you can put your rack in, and then you can use one of your pans and cook a pan of rice right on top of the food, and the steam from whatever you're cooking underneath is enough to build up the pressure, and that will cook your rice in the pan, so you kind of have a one pot meal. I do have a video on making rice in the Instant Pot, and in that video I go in depth about how to cook pot and pie rice if that's something you want to do, and I will put that video up in the cards as well as down in the description if you're interested in more details on that. Now, you do have the lid that is able to go in the Instant Pot as well, and you will want to use the lid or not depending on what you're cooking. For example, if you're cooking like banana bread or cornbread or something like that that you don't want a bunch of the steam to get into and to get too wet, then you would want to put the lid on. If you're cooking something like rice where the steam is not going to hurt it, then you could just leave it uncovered, that's no problem. If you're steaming vegetables, you could leave the lid off as well. Now, as far as this divider, the main thing that I see this useful for is if you are doing a lot of reheating individual meals. I don't find a lot of use for this in cooking for my family because usually I'm cooking a big amount of everything, and so this just doesn't really come in handy, but I love that it is removable. It's not fixed in there, so I can use the pan for something else. If I do want to just reheat stuff for myself, I can put the divider in. So maybe you could have some frozen veggies in here, some rice or grain that you wanted to reheat, some meat over here, and you can use your Instant Pot kind of like a microwave substitute. It also comes in handy to have the lid and to prep meals and have them in here. If you know you're gonna have to run in and get dinner really fast, you could prep your meal in this, put the lid on, stick it in the fridge, and then when you get home after a busy day, pull it out, throw it in your Instant Pot with some water underneath on the rack and heat it up, and then you have a nice hot dinner. Another thing that I'll mention about the pan is that these work well in air fryers as well. We have a set of stackable pans, and we find we use them in the air fryer quite a bit. The kids love to make our 3-ingredient granola, and these pans fit perfectly in our air fryer, and that's actually what we primarily use the pans for. A few more ideas of what you can make in a pan like this. You could do enchiladas, you could do lasagna, you could do an egg casserole, you could even cook like banana bread or a boxed cake even would work in this pan. Really anything that you would bake in the oven in a pan like this, you can make it in the Instant Pot. And if you're wondering why you would want to make it in the Instant Pot rather than in the oven, certain things just taste better if they're cooked with steam, the way the Instant Pot cooks, rather than cooked in the oven. For example, cheesecakes is one really big example of something that just is amazing out of the Instant Pot. And the main reason for that is that the Instant Pot cooks with steam, so it doesn't allow the cheesecake to dry out. When you stick it in the oven, oftentimes people will put in a pan of water in the oven to make the oven steam in order to not let the cheesecake dry out. But with the Instant Pot, you don't even have to worry about that because it is cooking with steam already. All right, now on to the removable bottom pan. Of course, you could do cheesecake in this, and that would be probably the main use for a pan like this. Other things you can do in it, you could do anything that you would have done in here, you can do it in here. It works well for things like banana bread, cheesecake, egg casseroles, anything that you want to come out of the pan really nicely, you can use the removable bottom pan. And when using either of these pans in the Instant Pot, you can either use the tall trivet if you want to have something cooking underneath, or you can just use the short trivet and add a cup or two of water down below, and that is what we call pot and pot cooking. One more tip about the removable bottom pan. When you have your food cooked in there and you're ready to remove it from the pan, what I found to work best is a jar or a cup. Use this nice wide mouth mason jar and you just set your pan on top and press the sides carefully and it comes out really nicely. I hope that gave you guys some good ideas of things you can do with Instant Pot accessories. I will link here at the end my playlist for all of my pot and pot cooking. That's going to include things like the sous vide egg bites and poached eggs, pot and pot rice, cheesecakes, and lots more. So check the card here at the end. I'll also put a link down in the description. Thanks, guys. I'll see you again in the next video.